we get to see a newborn. This one's gonna be special because there's a couple things that are different.
Hello, how are you?
So, for our viewers, one thing I just look at with newborns is their color. And you can see there's just a little hint of yellow here. Babies are born very pink, so it's not surprising to see a bit of a pink skin, but you can look on the forehead, and if I blanch this pink, underneath it's somewhat yellowish. That's sort of a yellowish color. We call that jaundice, and it's a very natural thing caused by the bilirubin being high. Now, you look at that belly button there, you can see some redness. That's just a little irritated. I'm not worried about it. I can move this around. So the yellow color that babies have starts at the head and then moves on down the body. And we can see we've got a little bit of yellow on the chest here. And newborn jaundice levels start below 5 for bilirubin, and they peak at about day 3-4 at about typically 10 to 15. If it's over that, we get concerned because high bilirubin levels for a long time. So if you see jaundice all the way down to the legs, which maybe there's a little here, then we might be in a position where it's a little bit high. Why do babies get yellow? Well, they're born with extra red blood cells. When babies are in the womb, they're extracting all their oxygen from the umbilical cord, and so they need extra red blood cells to carry that oxygen. As soon as they're disconnected from mom and they're breathing on their own, a lot of these red blood cells break apart and release a pigment called bilirubin, which makes you yellow. So it's completely normal to be a bit yellow, but if it gets too high, over 15 to 20, and it lasts too long, over a week or two or three, it can be bad for brain development, so that's why we track it. Don't worry, we're not gonna miss a single case of high bilirubin ever. Don't worry. We are on this. I'm gonna show you the nomogram that shows us what the normal range is based on age right now. This is the Bhutani nomogram that has been used by pediatricians for probably 20 years. And I wanna point out here, on this axis, you have serum bilirubin levels going all the way up from 0 to 25. And on this axis, you have their age in hours. Now notice, at 24 hours, below 5 is no big deal, low risk. Above 8 is high risk. Jump just a day older, and now low risk is 9. High risk, 13. Let's go to 3 or 4 days old, and you now have to be around 16, 17 to be high risk. There's a huge change in normal bilirubin levels over the first week of life, peaking at around day 4 or 5. And so it's vital that you know, if you're looking at a bilirubin number, how old was that baby when that bilirubin was drawn? Vital to know. And if it's low risk, low intermediate risk, you don't even have to worry about it, especially if they're feeding well. I generally don't worry if they're high intermediate risk, this sort of intermediate high zone, as long as the babies are feeding well and having lots of wet diapers, you know they're gonna flush it out. It gets worrisome when they're having feeding problems and you're high intermediate or very high risk. And basically you just don't wanna get behind so that you have this, think of the area under the curve here as the amount of bilirubin that brain is being exposed to. And if you awash that brain with bilirubin and it continues for 2 or 3 weeks, now you have risk for kernicterus, which is permanent brain damage, seizures, it's horrible. I've only seen one case, I'm gonna make sure I never see another. It's simple to take care of. Fluids and light therapy, boom, it's done. So I wanna thank you guys for watching. I'm Dr. Paul, and thank this amazing family for sharing this beautiful experience. There's nothing like a fresh baby, a newborn, to just get us excited about life.
That's so true.
Absolutely. So thank you guys.